Hello everybody, today I have a look at two really affordable knives. Affordable thanks, or you could say perhaps because of, globalization. I'm talking about the very popular Spyderco Tenacious and its recently introduced smaller brother, the Persistence. So, well, you all know Spyderco as being a truly high quality company with for most of their designs prices to match. However, they have a number of relatively affordable knives which very sometimes are made in America but often are made in Japan. Now, for a lot of, you could say, occasional knife users, these prices are still too much, and quite a few people still would like something else than a Victorinox, which are fantastic general tools, but many people would like still to have a sturdy blade at a lower price than what a typical Spyderco offers. And actually, Spyderco has an alternative already in the market. They call this bird knives, with a somewhat different, indeed, bird eye like form for the blade. Made in China, up to a pretty good standard. But of course, psychologically, it is not a Spyderco, which in marketing, from a marketing point of view, is of course less attractive, even if the birds are honestly pretty good in their own. So, at roughly a year ago, the Tenacious saw the light, being made in China, Spyderco, not made in Taiwan, which a number of new Spydercos are, and these are truly really good, but here really a value priced knife made in mainland China. And really called, it's called a Spyderco, it's not called a bird, it has the typical round opening hole. This, you could say, yes, it's probably marketing to attract potential buyers. Yeah, that must be a factor, but it also shows, I think, that the owners of Spyderco must have been pretty convinced of the quality of, let's say, Chinese manufacturing these days, that they put their own Spyderco name on it. And so, yes, it must be said, the Tenacious is pretty good indeed. It's a general utility knife that is perfectly satisfactory for all, I would say, average users. If indeed you're really into knives, you may balk a bit at the idea that the steel is HCR13, which is a Chinese steel, which, well, it's not the same as the high-end steels that a number of other Spydercos have, but it is pretty good in its own. It's like AUS 8 or 440C. I mean, you can really use this quite a bit, and indeed, yeah, you need to sharpen it a bit more, but let's not dramatize that. So, what do we have? A knife with G10 handles, with a good grippy texture, nice thick metal liners, 1.5mm I would say. I open it, and the Tenacious had a somewhat different kind of blade form as many other Spydercos, which are purely leaf shaped. I really like, I must say, the shape of the Tenacious blade and its single curve. I think it works really well for cutting in general. The jimping here can help a bit for precision cutting with some force still. And indeed, it is good in the hand. It is, you notice, it is a bit less slick when opening and closing than one of the higher end Spydercos, but at the price, honestly, it's quite amazing. Even the liner is 1.5mm here, the liner looks, is quite sturdy. Well, I'm curious when it will wear out, but I use it already quite a bit for mundane cutting task on cardboard and so on, and it works really well for that. So a good shape, good in the hand, light, yes, and good value for money, and it's easy to see why it's so successful. Are there alternatives for these knives? Well, in one of my other reviews I mentioned the Browning Ice Storm, which is actually a wonderful Makusta, being where the last pieces are being sold off at a ridiculous price, roughly like this. I would say that is a higher quality than the Tenacious, the Browning Ice Storm. That is really a class on its own, and if you can still find it, I think that's really incredible. The bird knife that I just showed is the Karakara. Where the blade is a bit longer, so it's roughly 8.5 centimeters, a bit more than 3 inches on the 10 aces. The bird is really, the Karakara G10 is really every bit the same quality as the 10 aces. Perhaps it's even the same company. I would say which one to choose? Well, perhaps you really want the Spyderco name, which I think is part of the success, commercial success of the 10 aces. But otherwise, if you prefer a backlog, well, then the Karakara is pretty good as well. It uses the same steel, by the way. It's also very sturdy. So that's an interesting, alternative. What else I would say? Well, I mean, if you're more traditional, something else that I discussed previously is a Sodbuster. Yeah, indeed, it may seem strange to compare them, but a Sodbuster is a classic utility knife. This is a German Iwan from Karl Schlieper, carbon steel. Yes, you must take care of it a bit. Yes, you have to sharpen it a bit more, but it's a perfectly satisfactory, nicely made knife with a lot of character. I personally think, I mean, even yes, its yellow handle, which looks a bit like ivory micarta, is nice in the hand. I must say, I personally think it's, for general utility, it appeals to me more than the Tinesius. But okay, that's a matter of taste. But just to show you, yes, there are alternatives also from other brands, which also tend to go towards the Chinese to produce for them relatively decent knives at a good price. But here with the Schlieper, you have something, I would say, authentic for the same price. So that is, I mean, that in my opinion, that's quite an alternative. Now, so the Tenacious, really good. I must say, in some way, it's one of the very few knives where I managed to cut my finger. I don't know how I did that. It slipped my hand in some way, but however, ergonomics, I would say, are normally really good. Yes, you can put the clip in the four places. That can be useful for you as well. So, that's the Tenacious. And now the Persistence, the smaller brother. I will open the big one again. So, think everything what I said about the Tenacious, but on a somewhat smaller scale, because Tenacious, especially if you are around non-knife people, may still be a bit big. The Persistence is a perfect EDC, you could say. A blade which is something like 7 centimeters, so it's a bit less than 3 inches. And it's really good in the hand. The blade form is a scale model, you also from the big one. A nicely adjusted liner lock. Again, it's not as smooth as, let's say, the higher end Spyderco's. I mean, here you have, for example, the one made in Taiwan, not in mainland China, is the Sage, which cost indeed more. But it's smoother all around. When you flick it open, the handles, the liners are more polished. It feels slicker all the way. Huh? But I must say, for a value price knife, this one is really pretty good. I forgot to say about the big one, and this one has that as well. You can maybe just make it see it in the camera. The liners are skeletonized, so there are holes in it, which make it a bit lighter. So that is, I think that's good engineering. So really sturdy blade, the same thickness here as the other one, is around 3 millimeters. So a very nice utility at a really good price. I can see why these knives have a lot of appeal if you are on a budget. Or if you're a casual knife user, I understand that people do not want to go immediately for more upper-end Spyderco, like the famous Cali Trio, like this Sage, for example. These ones are definitely for occasional use perfectly satisfactory. So, Tenacious, Persistence, and I mentioned a few interesting alternatives, like the Karl Schlieper. I hope you found this an interesting overview, and as usual, feel free to leave feedback.